And I went down there, and Reg picked me up at the airport, and I stayed at his house. And something unbelievable happened. I mean, it was this great, great hospitality, where he, you know, we had the greatest food, and we were sitting out there in the gardens, and we were eating and having a great time. And then all of a sudden, we went to sleep. Reg woke me up at 4:30 in the morning. As you probably all know, he also started that. There was no one around before him that ever started working out at 5 o'clock in the morning. So he woke me up. I had no idea about this. So he woke me up at 4:30 in the morning, and I sat with him outside of the kitchen, and he gave me cornflakes and with the Reg Park protein powder on top of the cornflakes. Tasted like sugar. So it was really, there was maybe 2% protein in there and 90% sugar. I mean, otherwise it couldn't have tasted so delicious. But it was this delicious protein powder. I thought it was Reg Park protein, so therefore I'm going to gain. You know, it's all in your mind. So I did gain. I mean, it was not all muscles, I have to admit. But I mean, I did gain from all this stuff. But we went to the gym then. And then in the gym, we started squatting. And it was 135, and the next set was 225, and the next set was 275, then it was 315, then 375, 415. And this is how it went on. All the way up to 455 pounds, and I'm looking at the watch now, and it was 5:30 in the morning. I mean, I said, Reg, who the hell squats with 500 pounds at 5:30 in the morning? Why? I came down here to make some money, to do some exhibitions, and to learn from you, but not to get tortured. What is this? And he says, never mind, just keep going, boy. And we kept training. And I learned something from all of this, is that you shouldn't waste your morning. That the morning is there to train. This is how you can pile in 2 workouts a day, how important that is. I learned this whole new thing of training twice a day, and it's still the day to do exactly the same thing. Train twice a day. Get up early in the morning, work a little cardiovascular training, and at night do the weight training. It's something that I learned from Reg, and he has been doing it his whole life. Was this other side that I, of course, never knew and wasn't really written about in the magazines. Like, for instance, what an incredible family man he was. I tell you, I've never had that in my house because my father was a more disciplinarian. There was not that warmth in our house. But when I was there in South Africa and I was sitting there every day, I was there for 3 weeks, I was sitting every day with that family. The way he loved his kids, the way he hugged his kids, the way he kissed his kids, the way he set them in the lap, the way he joked with them, he played sports with them, they swam together, everything they did together, they went out to restaurants together, we went to Durban and to Cape Town and all, it was always the family. And I just loved it, I fell in love with it. That became a new inspiration for me, that I saw myself, when I make some money and when I can get to America eventually and all of those kind of dreams that I had, I want to have a family like this. I think that one of the things I have to say is when I watched him this last 8 months is Reg didn't only teach us how to live and how to be successful, but Reg taught us how to die. He did. I mean, every single time when I called him, I mean, it was the most unbelievable thing. He never whined. He never was complaining. He was the, before I ever could get the first word out, Reg would say, "How are you, my son? How are you, my friend? How are you?" I said, "No, no, I'm calling about you." He said, "No, forget that." He says, "How are you? Tell me, how is the family? How are the kids?" That's the kind of a person he was until the last minute. So we will miss.